All right, love him or hate him, conservative political consultant and convicted felon Roger Stone is getting involved in Southwest Florida politics.
Stone was in town to endorse some Republican candidates in local races, and he talked exclusively with NBC2 chief political correspondent Dave Elias for his first face-to-face interview since President Trump commuted his sentence.
Okay. Hello, sir. How are you doing?
Nice to see you.
Roger Stone is entering Collier County politics and endorsing longtime friend Joanne DiBartolo.
Are you winning?
Of course I'm winning.
Great.
Traffic U.S.
And Alfie Oaks as Republican state committee members.
I will be supporting you and Joanne.
You're getting involved in Southwest Florida politics. Talk a little bit about what brought you here.
This is ground zero for the grassroots Trump organizations.
But staying out of a dirty 9-member GOP congressional race, sort of.
I'm taking no endorsement because Byron Donalds and Dane Eagle are both friends. I like both of them.
Ironically, are you able to vote in this election?
I probably will not be able to vote in this election, even though Florida does have a protocol for convicted felons to get their vote back. But I will be able to vote once I am exonerated, which I expect to be.
You were this close to going to jail.
I think the president undertook a very courageous act of mercy and justice.
Were you sweating it, or did you have faith that the president would commute your sentence?
Well, faith is exactly the right word, because I had no assurances or promises or guarantees.
What was that phone call like with the president when he gave you the news?
He said, I've decided in an act of clemency to commute your sentence. This is not a pardon. I urge you to appeal, to exonerate yourself, because I think you got screwed, his word. Also, he says, I'm very concerned about your being sent to a prison where there clearly is COVID-19 virus at your age and in your condition.
You came in wearing an attention-getting mask. Do you support masks? There's a lot of controversy over it.
Well, I do not think COVID-19 is a hoax. I do think it is not as transferable as we originally thought. I still take precautions because of my own situation.
A black radio talk show host has accused you of calling him a Negro.
Categorically false. Actually, today, I have finally found a sound engineer who is willing to release the results of an analysis. That is spliced together. You can actually tell if you listen to the background noise.
Your thoughts on the Black Lives Matter and the protests that have been going on around the country?
This is not an indigenous uprising. This is a revolt. I'm not in favor of statues to Confederate heroes. I'm opposed to that.
They took down the bust of General Lee in Lee County. Should it stay down?
I think it should stay down. I mean, look, these people were traitors to the United States. But at the same time, when you tear down a statue of Abraham Lincoln, that makes no sense to me.
And I've read where you have renewed your faith after this.
I admit that I had fallen away. And I understand that there are people who are going to watch this, are going to say, come on, that's a head fake, that's a ploy. Stone is just posturing for public sympathy.
So are we seeing a new Roger Stone?
The old Roger Stone, the one who's half Sicilian, would be plotting revenge against those who have wronged me. I now recognize that's not my place.
He says that his place now is to see the president reelected.
Just to be absolutely clear.
And he has no plans to leave Florida.
Thanks so much.
Dave Elias, NBC2.
Thanks for sticking up for the American people.
Thank you.